Hi, my name is Lorna Mothania Ochido, and I'm making it one of my life's mission to demystify the speech therapy field and to empower more parents on what they can start to do in order to optimize their child's communication outcomes. So whether you want your child to talk more or talk better, learn better, and overall optimize their potential. So stay tuned and feel free to send in any topics on speech and language development you'd like for me to tackle. Welcome to today's My Opinion About series. And today's topic is reading disorders. So what should you do if you find out that your child or you suspect that your child is struggling with reading? So before we get started, let me know in the comments below. So answer this question. Do you know that speech therapists work with children who have reading disorders? Yes or no? Do you know? Yes. Did you not know? Put a no. And I will tell you though. So yes, speech therapists who have specialized in literacy disorders can and do offer therapy to children who are struggling with their literacy skills. So literacy skills simply refers to reading, writing, and spelling. So if your child is in kinder, that's spelling or reading, then writing is much later. So what should you do if you identify or you suspect that your child is not making sufficient progress with their reading? That, by the way, is what dyslexia refers to, or dyslexia means, not making sufficient reading progress in spite of intervention or schooling. Most parents I've encountered in Kenya would probably approach their child's teacher to offer some before or after school tutoring. Yeah, that sounds familiar. And other parents may adopt a wait and see approach, which I should add is not such a great idea if you take into consideration what I am going to say next. Reading skills are foundational. They are foundational to most other academic skills, and they determine the level of success your child will experience at school. Imagine reading skills does that. And several researchers have even gone as far as to peg a student's reading skills or a student's reading performance to school dropout rates and such factors as confidence, earning power, so many other different things. And so how do you identify, or how would you identify if your child is struggling with reading? Well, the telltale signs for struggling readers are usually easy to spot. So if your child is difficult to motivate during reading activities, is displaying oppositional behavior, or even meltdowns during reading-related activities, if your child prefers to guess than attempt reading words, you know, very important. And I guess some of these telltale signs need to coexist. You don't just have a child that is difficult to motivate and yet they don't guess. When they have a book, they're actually able to word attack properly, then that child really does not qualify as having a reading disorder. But if they are difficult to motivate, they prefer that you read the text instead of them reading the text. They are struggling with different subjects at school, perhaps are making slow progress compared to their age-matched peers, so their classmates, and in spite of adequate literacy instruction. So if you've kept them home, they've not gone to school, and they've now suddenly gone to school and they are struggling, then you can't say that it's a reading disorder because they've not had the instruction. Yeah? Or, you know, if your child's teacher has raised a concern with your child's reading skills, or if you yourself as a parent feel that your child is not optimizing on their potential, or you suspect, you know, you have a gut feeling that they perhaps are struggling, then it's very likely that they are experiencing a literacy or reading disorder. So what should you do in that case if you suspect that your child may be struggling with reading? If you are able to access a reading or literacy specialist or a speech therapist who specializes in literacy disorders, then that will be my first recommendation. Now, I know in Kenya, they're not always readily available, but those are the people that are well trained to be able to assess and offer intervention to your child that has a reading disorder. I strongly recommend doing your due diligence on the qualification of the specialist you should evaluate your child, as picking someone who isn't specialized in this area may delay or hinder your child's progress. So it is not unheard of for children experiencing reading disorders not to make sufficient reading progress. even after going through years, and I mean years of learning support or reading recovery. So overseas, I know in Australia, they have a term, even New Zealand, they call it reading recovery. And there's research about that and how sometimes it doesn't translate to gains. And if you consider that a child's reading difficulties can be successfully remediated within a significantly short period of time with appropriate intervention, it is incredibly unfortunate to correctly identify that, you know, the presence of a disorder or an issue, and then offer an intervention that does not, or that does very little to change the child's reading outcomes. The difference between a specialist or specialist intervention and tutoring, which most parents, you know, I know in Kenya that I've encountered would go for, I'll explain, yeah? So, you know, and I do understand why most parents would seek a tutor for their child who isn't making reading progress. But if a targeted approach to the tutoring or intervention isn't used, then your child can stand a real chance of not making sufficient progress. A better approach, you know, would be to evaluate a child that is suspected to have a reading disorder. So evaluate a complete overall assessment, because literacy skills, as I mentioned, are strongly linked. No, actually, I didn't mention this. But literacy skills are strongly linked to phonological awareness, or the explicit awareness of sound structure within words. So phonological awareness, or PA, skills are in turn strongly linked with communication, so speech and language skills. So you can say that literacy skills are very much linked to speech and language skills, yeah? Research has found that literacy skills are pegged on how well a child's phonological awareness skills are, and further propose that children first learn to read a word through the phonological route. So this is getting a bit more complex, but in the blog, I'll explain more there. Phonological awareness can be categorized into three areas, so rhyme awareness, syllable awareness, and phoneme awareness. And mastery of all three of these areas is fundamental in ensuring literacy success. So a child that has a reading disorder or reading, you know, difficulties should be evaluated. So we evaluate the foundational skills to reading that your child, so which of those skills, foundational skills to reading, has your child mastered, and which of those is your child struggling with. And then the intervention should aim to strengthen, obviously, the weak skills and boost confidence of the already established skills. This is what I mean. So if your child is good at pulling apart sounds, which is also referred to as phoneme segmentation, and not, say, generating rhyme, which is also, you know, a very important part of phonological awareness. So as you work on firming up rhyme generation, which serves its purpose, but I'm not going to talk about this now, you could actually provide the child with opportunities to, you know, practice the skills that he's already good at, so the segmentation. So you do this by offering them skill appropriate, so not age appropriate, skill appropriate opportunities for them to practice what they already know so that they can get a sense of success. Oftentimes, children with reading disorders do not experience enough success with their reading, which causes them to hate reading. And if you gave a child who is struggling to read a very difficult text or book to read, then it diminishes their confidence in the skills that they probably already know, because the book is not predictable enough. You know, they get a text and they thought, oh, I can segment three letter words, but then it's four letters, it's blends, it's everything. So it becomes very erratic and doesn't really boost confidence. So that's it for today. Please do check out our other videos if this topic brought up something that you need to explore further. And as always, thank you so much for tuning in. I'll appreciate if you can leave a comment below. As I said, if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, please do so. And don't forget to hit the notification bell. That way you will receive a notification when I publish, you know, a new video. So thank you so much.